What's up, everybody? Back at it again today with another video. Hope everybody is doing well. I just got done power washing my house. So, yeah, it's been a busy day for me. It is currently 10:22 at night, and yes, I just fucking finished. So, yeah, it's been a long fucking day. I started about noon. But, yeah, it's been a long day. A very long day. But I said, hey, I need to do this review. Because my subscribers and my followers want this review. They need this review. So, here we are. Ready to do this fucking review. Alright, let's go ahead and get you guys a description of this stuff. We're also going to do a VR to Youssef Saeed, who is another presenter in the YTPC. Alright, so. And I keep forgetting the password to my fucking Kindle. Alright, here we go. Let me get my eyeballs so I can read this shit for you guys. Alright, so. You can get this at Pipes and Cigars. There, it has a 4.5-star rating. Okay, so. I'm expecting maybe something pretty damn good for a 4-star rating. Let's see. Lane Limited's Very Cherry begins with a mellow nutty burley and smooth sweet Virginias, along with a touch, just a touch, of Lane's famous Black Cavendish. Yeah. To create an easy smoking blend, by the way. That you might think would be enough, but Lane turns up that dial by adding one of the zestiest cherry flavors you will ever encounter. The flavor is somewhat subdued, but the aroma will please anyone who loves the aroma of cherries. They had it right when they named it Very Cherries. How much this shit gonna cost you? Alright, 1-pound bag, $38.25. 8-ounce bag, $19.97. 4-ounce bag, $10.65. 2-ounce bag, $5.60. 1-ounce, which is what I got, $2.97. Alright. So, enough of that. Alright, so. This is what the blend looks like. Now, I'm going to tell you guys, this stuff is extremely moist. Now, I used a coffee filter to drain some of the, to dry it up a little bit, I should say. That's the reason why the coffee filter looks like shit. But there you go. That's what it looks like. And it smells just like cherries. It really does. The aroma on this stuff is amazing. I'm going to tell you that right now. But there you go. Okay. So, but yeah, it's got a nice, Jesus, holy fucking Christ, dude. I didn't put this stuff out at literally at 10 o'clock this morning. It is still wet. Holy Christ. Tongue bite. That's what that says to me. Tongue bite. Oh well. I'm gonna still give it a shot. Now the pipe I'm gonna be trying it in is, this is called Thompson. Okay, I don't know the name of this pipe. I bought this pipe from Tobacconist Raleigh in 2000. Now it's no longer a thing. All right, it was a mom and pop shop, husband and wife operation, and they were really, really good people. Okay, they were really nice, awesome folks. But when she died, he literally fell apart and died very shortly afterwards. Then their daughter took over and she ended up selling it. She ended up closing down Tobacconist of Raleigh, kept Tobacconist of Cary open, but then she ended up shutting down Tobacconist of Raleigh. And then she sold Tobacconist of Cary, to which I'm really good friends with the new owner and everything. But I haven't talked to her since about 2005, 2006, somewhere around there. Was the last time I actually talked to her. But anyhow. Yeah. That's what it's called. A Thompson. So. I may, next time, next year when I go to Gatlinburg, I may take this, the Gatlin Burlier and see if Dread Tiger can identify this pipe. Because the problem is the briar's just so faded. I mean, it says Thompson's, but underneath it's just so faded I can't read that shit. I just can't. But, yeah. That's probably what I'll end up doing. But anyhow, let's go ahead and light it up and see what we're working with. Now, the tin note, awesome. It's a really good aroma. The room note, you can tell this stuff's been working. This is an amazing aroma. Now the flavor, it's very chemical. Okay, it's a very chemical tasting cherry to me. It reminds me of the Captain Black cherry. But we're going to sip on this for a while. And I'm going to talk. I'm going to blab and tell you guys. And give this response to Yousef. And tell him how I got into the YTPC. Well, back when Scott from Arista Cob was doing videos on how custom cobs, he was customizing cobs and everything. That was about 2013, I want to say. Yeah. That was the first pipe video I ever watched. But I lurked around the community, you know. I really wasn't very active in commenting or anything like that. And there was another guy that I watched. I don't know his name. But then you had Mutton Chop Piper. He came on the scene. And then you got Matches 860, John Harden, RIP John. He came on the scene. And actually, as far as interaction went, John was really the only one at that time that I interacted with when I first came around. He was really the only one. And then I had a choice. I was at a crossroads because I was like this. I was like, do I want to do pipe videos or vape videos? I found vaping more interesting because, in my opinion, and this is still my opinion, vaping is a great way to get people off traditional combustible cigarettes. And before anybody's like, well, you're doing a pipe video, you know, so how can you promote vaping and pipe smoking? Pipe smoking, cigarette smoking, and cigar smoking are three totally different things. The only thing they have in common is that they use the tobacco product. That's it. They use tobacco. But as for the methods and the way you smoke, it's three different, totally different experiences. All right. So, where was I? Oh yeah, went to the vaping community, started doing vape reviews. In 2019, the lung illnesses from vaping hit. And then they started really coming down hard on vaping. And so it was getting really hard to get our shit from mail order. Custom was seizing vaping shit from China. So it was just extremely, extremely difficult to keep a review channel with vapes going. Unless you want to do fucking disposables. And I'm not doing disposables, okay? I still say this. Even 5 years after I tried my first vape product, the Vuse Alto is the superior vaping product. If you want to get people off of cigarettes. Yeah. Bar none. Get the fuck out of here if you want to argue with me about it. The Vuse Alto is absolutely the best. It's a pod system. You throw in the pod, you vape. You don't have to worry about fucking wattages. You don't have to worry about changing coils. You don't have to worry about adding juice. You just put in a new pod and you vape. and they're affordable. Best thing about them. But anyhow, okay. After that, I had, it started becoming more about the drama in that community than it did about the product. And when it becomes more about the drama than about the product, then what the fuck are you doing? So I decided to leave the vape community and the vape scene. And I'm not going to make any excuses for it. I did participate in that drama. I really did. You know, I thought it was fun. But then after a while, it just got boring, repetitive bullshit. So then I just left. I was like, fuck you guys, I'm out. Then I went over to the real crime scene. Or the true crime community. And you want to talk dumpster fire? That place is a fucking dumpster fire. Dumpster fire. But during that time, I still watched videos from the YTPC. And then you had Edward Hobbs who came up on the scene. Then you had the Pipe Cottage, which started coming up on the scene. I really didn't watch George Bruno until later. Until much, much later. I didn't, I actually know anything about George Bruno. And what was that? I was looking for something. And I forgot one of his videos came up. I was like, oh, cool, he smokes pipes. And then also, during the time when I stopped doing the reviews and the vape reviews and left the vape scene in 2021, early 2021, my wife died. So, you know, I was 2 years of piddling around, you know, things of that nature. And then I moved on with my life. I got myself back together and decided, hey, I wanted to go ahead and start doing YouTube again. And I watched one of Tunnel Take Greg's videos. And that's actually what motivated me to actually do a pipe tobacco review. Because he did one. And I was like, you know what? The pipe tobacco thing is very interesting. Much more interesting than vaping now. So, I'm going to do that. So that's what I did. So, that, Mr. Youssef, is how I got into the YTPC. All right. All right. I gotta tell you, this stuff tastes too much like Captain Black Cherry to me. And I hate Captain Black Cherry. Now, that's not to be confused with Captain Black Red Sky, which is another cherry blend from Captain Black. It's one of their premium blends. Both tobaccos, both cherry, miles apart. Miles apart. If you have never tried Captain Black Red Sky, I don't know what you have been doing with yourself. And for an aromatic, it ages amazingly. It aged amazingly. But this shit right here is more like the Captain Black Cherry. Very chemical flavor. By the way, this pipe is unfiltered, by the way. The room note on this thing is fucking amazing. I wish that it tasted like it smelled. And the tongue bite, you get a little sizzle there. This is one you're going to want to sip, not puff on it like you're a damn freight train. Yeah, I'm starting to get a little tongue bite from it. But this stuff, guys, you will have to dry out. You will have to. There's just no getting around that, okay? It is so goopy, so fucking moist. It is not a dry tobacco. I don't know what I'm going to do. I mean, literally, I left this shit out for 12 hours. And it's still moist. It is still wet. still goopy. I can put it together and look at this. Make a cigar. God damn. That's wet. I may have to damn empty the, well, not empty, but I may have to go ahead and just put that out or fire up the oven and cook it for a little bit to cook off some of that moisture, because this thing is amazingly, wow. That's all I got to say on that. But yeah, dry it out first, okay? Otherwise, you're going to be like me and have a hard time keeping this shit lit. All right. But yeah, room note, amazing. Taste, not so much. This is what I would call a flu blend. You know what a flu blend is? Anybody care to take a guess? All right, a flu blend is when you have the flu, you feel like smoking something. You smoke this because you can't taste it. But it's got that cough syrup cherry flavor that Captain Black Cherry has. And yeah. Do you hear that sizzle and pop from the moisture in this thing? Yeah. Okay. Ratings time. 0 being the worst. 5 being the best. 2.5. Solid 2.5. The flavor? Robitussin. Okay. Room note, amazingly, amazing. Surprisingly, it's amazing. And that is the only thing that saves this tobacco, that makes this tobacco a worthy addition to anybody's rotation, is the amazing room note. Your wife, girlfriend, kids, whatever, will not have a problem with this blend because it is that, it smells that good. It really does. But I'm going to suffer through that damn flavor just to make the house smell nice. Hey, I made larger sacrifices for myself. But anyway, guys, hope you guys enjoyed this review. Yousef, I hope that is a good enough answer to your question, my brother. And for everybody else, thank you very much for watching. Comment, subscribe. Hit that like button. Hit that bell for notifications of new content first. And remember, folks, live long and prosper. And we'll see you next time. Bye.